examination of motor functions. It involves examination of following, which starts with examination of tone of muscles, then examination of power of muscles, then examination of nutrition of muscles, and coordination of muscular movements. Today we'll discuss about tone and power of muscles. Let us start with tone of muscles. Tone is defined as resistance offered by muscle while performing passive movements. When tone of the muscle is reduced, it is termed as hypotonia, where no resistance will be felt while performing passive movements. When tone is increased, it is termed as hypertonia. Hypertonia is of following varieties, that is clasp knife, lead pipe, then cogwheel and hysteric. Now, next is power of the muscles. Power is tested by examining ability of the subject to perform movements against resistance offered by the examiner. There are different grades of the power, which starts with grade 0 to grade 5. Grade 0 means no movement at all. Grade 1 is trace of muscle contractions. Grade 2 is active movement with gravity eliminated. Grade 3 is active movement against gravity. Grade 4 is active movements against gravity with moderate resistance. And grade 5 is active movement against gravity with full resistance.
Now, let us do examination on subject. Ask the subject to relax completely. Passively move the joint, for example, metacarpophalangeal joint. And compare it on the opposite side. This is how we can examine tone. Now, to assess the power of the muscle, ask the subject to move the joint against resistance offered by the examiner. Always compare whenever you assess tone and power to the opposite side of the body. Let us examine group of the muscles acting on finger joints. Flexor group of the muscles. Examine power of the flexor group of the muscle. Ask the subject to flex the finger against resistance offered by examiner. Flexor group of muscles acting on the finger joints can also be assessed by ability of the subject to grasp an object. Now, power of the adductors on finger joints. Place papers between adjacent fingers and see whether the subject can hold paper tightly or not when the papers are pulled away. Compare it on the opposite side. Power of the abductors. It is examined by ability of the subject to open fingers against resistance. Compare it on the opposite side. Now, let us examine flexor group of metacarpophalangeal joints. Ask the subject to move the finger against resistance offered by examiner and compare it on the opposite side. Now, let us assess extensors of interphalangeal joints. Ask the subject to extend the fingers against resistance offered by examiner and compare it on the opposite side. Now, movement of thumb. All the movements should be tested against resistance. See the ability to move the thumb inward, that is flexion of the thumb. Then movement of the thumb outward, that is extension of thumb. movement of thumb like abduction and adduction. The movement are at the right angle to the palm. Check the abduction of thumb. Then adduction of thumb. Then opposition to little finger. To assess the power of flexor group of muscles of wrist joint, ask the subject to bring his finger towards the forearm while examiner will offer resistance against the movement. Compare it on the opposite side. To assess the power of the extensors of wrist joint, ask the subject to make a fist and try to extend the wrist against resistance. Compare it on the opposite side. Now, power of the flexors of elbow joint. It is examined by ability to flex the forearm at elbow joint against resistance. Compare it on the opposite side. To assess the power of extensors of elbow joint, ask the subject to flex the forearm and see the ability to extend the elbow against resistance. And compare on the opposite side. Now let us assess power of abductors of the shoulder joint. Ask the subject to move the upper limb opposed to the trunk and see the ability to abduct the limb against resistance. And compare it on the opposite side. Now let us examine power of adductors of shoulder joint. It is examined by ability of the subject to adduct the arm against resistance from the position of abduction. Compare it on the opposite side. Group of muscles acting as an external rotator on shoulder joint. With arm adducted at shoulder and flexed at elbow, see the ability of the subject to rotate the upper limb laterally against resistance. Compare it on the opposite side. Now, power of the internal rotators of shoulder joint with arm adducted and externally rotated at shoulder and flexed at elbow. See the ability of the subject to rotate it medially against resistance. And compare it on the opposite side. Now, to assess the power of pectoralis muscle, ask the subject to stretch the arm forward and then clasp his hand against resistance. Now, power of latissimus dorsi muscle. Ask the subject to cough and feel the posterior axillary fold for the contraction. And compare on the opposite side. Now let us examine power of serratus anterior muscle. Ask the subject to push his outstretched arm against the wall and look for the winging of scapula. Same way, abductor muscles acting on the scapula can be tested. Now, elevators of scapula. Ask the subject to shrug his shoulder while the examiner tries to press them down from behind. Now let us examine depressors, group of muscles acting on scapula. Ask the subject to approximate the shoulder blades against resistance. Now flexors of the trunk. Ask the subject to raise himself in the bed with the hand of the examiner on his forehead to resist his efforts. Now, extensors of the trunk in prone position see the ability to raise his head against resistance. Now, power of sternocleidomastoid muscle asks the subject to turn the neck on the opposite side against resistance. Compare it on the opposite side. Now let us examine lower limb. First, flexors at hip joint, the knee being extended, ask the subject to raise his leg off the bed against resistance. And compare on opposite side. Then, extensors at hip joint, the knee being extended, lift the foot off the bed and ask him to bring it back to the bed against resistance. And compare. Then, abductors at hip joint, ask the subject to move the limb outward against resistance. And compare. Then, adductors at hip joint, with limb abducted, ask him to bring it inward against resistance and compare. Then, rotators at hip joint, with the limb extended on the bed, ask the subject to rotate outward while resistance is offered by the observer by grasping the foot. And compare. Now, flexors at knee joint, raise the limb from the bed supporting the thigh and ankle with hand and ask the subject to bend his knees. And compare on the opposite side of the body. Then, extensors at knee joint, bend the subject's knee and press with your hand on shin and ask him to straighten the leg. Compare on the opposite side. Now, muscles at ankle joint, dorsiflexors, ask the subject to elevate his foot against resistance. And compare. Then, plantar flexors, ask the subject to depress his foot against resistance. And compare. Then, muscles at foot, for eversion, ask him to turn his foot outward against resistance. And compare. Then, inverters, ask the subject to turn his foot inward against resistance. And compare. Now, group of muscles at toes, for flexors, ask the subject to plantar flex the toes against resistance. And compare. Then, extensors at toes, ask the subject to dorsiflex the toes against resistance. And compare. Now, different types of hypertonia. First, clasp knife effect. In this, while performing movements passively, the resistance initially will be there, that will be followed by release of resistance. Then next is lead pipe rigidity. In this, resistance will be felt throughout the movement. Then Cogwheel rigidity, resistance will be interrupted offered by the muscles.
Thank you.